We begin tonight with a KETK News exclusive. An East Texas family is begging for mercy for the sake of their son. He's in the hospital with a serious brain injury. But as KETK's Trent Bennett explains, the man's parents say his estranged wife disagrees with his treatment.
You've been awake a long time.
This is Jonathan Michael. He's 39 years old, and for his parents, their only son.
I would give my life for his. I'd rather me die than him.
On June 30th, he suffered a head injury, turned brain aneurysm. Jonathan has since been in this hospital bed at UT Health East Texas in Tyler. You can see him here clenching his mom's hand with his finger, signs that he's still there.
Not just my hands, but my arms, my face.
His family says that inside this hospital, Jonathan was getting life-saving help.
That was until his estranged wife stepped in and tried to put a stop to it.
As of yesterday at 11 o'clock, we were no longer allowed to visit him, nor is any pastor of any kind.
After we sat down with the Michael family preparing to tell their story, they tell us Jonathan's wife decided to allow them limited visits, and she has backed off her request to transfer him to another medical facility.
We want to deal with Jonathan's health and what's going on there, not other problems.
The dispute had become so serious, it was taken to a special UT Health Tyler team of experts.
The hospital ethics committee told us that, which we had to meet with, that as long as they was seeing progress, they would continue medical care to him.
Those experts sent KETK News this statement. Their role is to make recommendations for addressing ethical-related concerns such as end-of-life decisions. Before all of this, the family feared they might never see Jonathan alive again.
We have seen a miracle pretty much so far.
The power of social media has spread Jonathan's struggle far beyond the walls of this hospital. You can see it's been shared thousands of times on Facebook, and it caught the attention of this pastor. He's the director of Right to Life East Texas.
The signs of life here, unmistakable.
Jonathan's family now believes he will pull through. They've witnessed their son make progress from moving his legs again, even attempting to unlock this phone screen.
And the CEO of the hospital said that there's improvement in Jonathan's life.
Jonathan's future is uncertain.
If God wants him to go home, we don't want him to, but we know that he's made everything right with God, and we'll have to let him go.
But for now, mom and dad say they will cling to their faith, that this is in God's hands. Trent Bennett, KETK News.
We will update you if there is any change in Jonathan's condition. You can find that information on our website, easttexasmatters.com.